Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we'll be covering three updates today. We'll start with an update where SpaceX CEO has offered internet service in Ukraine, followed by US and other major allied nations being on their way to increasing cooperation in the space industry. Let's start with SpaceX's help to Ukraine amidst the present war situation. Recently, Elon Musk said that SpaceX's Starlink satellite internet service is now available in Ukraine, and more terminals to use it are on the way. The situation in Ukraine is worsening due to constant clashes between Russian and Ukrainian soldiers. Fighting is heaviest in eastern and southern parts of the country, and last Saturday Russia stated that they'll increase the wave of attacks on Ukraine from all directions. With these, the fight is increasing. Since the Russian invasion has started, Ukraine has seen a disruption of water services and other basic facilities as the Kremlin refuses to call back its troops. As per reports, NetBlocks, an internet monitor, stated that Ukraine has also seen a series of significant disruptions to internet service since Thursday, when Russia launched military operations in the country. Now, amidst this serious situation, SpaceX has helped Ukraine by starting their Starlink satellite connectivity there after the Vice Prime Minister had appealed to Musk. On the 26th of February, 2022, Ukraine's Vice Prime Minister Mykhailo Fedorov, who is also the country's Minister of Digital Transformation, wrote to Musk over Twitter that, "While you try to colonize Mars, Russia try to occupy Ukraine. While your rockets successfully land from space, Russian rockets attack Ukrainian civil people. We ask you to provide Ukraine with Starlink stations and to address sane Russians to stand." This tweet appeal by the Ukraine minister, linked to internet outages amid Russian offensive, got a reply from Elon Musk within hours, who got his SpaceX Starlink satellite broadband service active in the war-hit country. Within 10 hours after Fedorov had written this, Musk had replied that Starlink service is now active in Ukraine, more terminals en route. Ukrainian officials and analysts feared that Russia would cut off Ukraine's connection to the outside world, thus this step was taken to protect connection with the outer world. SpaceX's Starlink satellite internet connectivity technology has a good advantage of providing internet in distant, remote terrains and in harsh conditions where fiber optic cables and cell towers have no power to provide any sort of connectivity. Thus, in this critical wartime, SpaceX's Starlink will play a crucial role in terms of connectivity. Similarly, some weeks ago, Starlink had started providing free internet connectivity in the remote regions of the island nation named Tonga, where a massive volcanic eruption had happened followed by a strong tsunami. Starlink, at present, operates a constellation of more than 2,000 satellites that aim to provide internet access across the planet. Last Friday, SpaceX carried out another Starlink launch to low Earth orbit. In our next update, the US and other major allied nations are on their way to increase cooperation in the space industry. Recently, the US Defense Department announced that seven nations, including the US, have signed a joint vision document that will promote greater cooperation to prevent conflicts in space. According to reports, the document was the Combined Space Operations (CSPO) Vision 2031. This document will generate and improve cooperation, coordination, and interoperability opportunities to sustain freedom of action in space, optimize resources, enhance mission assurance and resilience, and prevent conflict. Reports say that this document was signed on the 22nd of February, and the signatory nations were the United States, Canada, France, Germany, Australia, the United Kingdom, and New Zealand. These nations have consented to abide by the principles like upholding international law, responsible and sustainable use of space, partnering while recognizing sovereignty, and also freedom in use of space. The Defense Department said the CSPO document is an initiative to address the overarching need to encourage responsible use of space, recognizing challenges to space sustainability, threats presented by technological advances, and the increasingly comprehensive and aggressive counter-space programs of other nation-states. Militaries have an important role in contributing to international efforts to ensure freedom of access to and use of space. The world is reliant on space-based systems. Activities in space have consequences across the spectrum of human activity. The Department of Defense also said that the officials of CSPO had earlier carried out a meeting in late December 2021. The objective of that meeting was reaffirming their nation's support to the vision, including the intent to prevent conflicts extending to or originating in space, and to hold accountable those who threaten the safety of the space environment and the space assets of others. In November 2021, Russia had carried out an anti-satellite missile test and had destroyed one of its own satellites. This destruction had created about 1,500 trackable pieces of debris in low Earth orbit, increasing risk on space operations and human spaceflight. And these led to the formation of the CSPO document. The Vision 2031 document points out that the CSPO participants will pursue space activities which will endeavor to minimize the creation of long-lived space debris. Let's move to our next update, where the Russia-Ukraine crisis may not influence ULA's upcoming Atlas V launches. According to recent reports, U.S. sanctions on Russia for their recent invasion of Ukraine will not hamper launches of ULA's Atlas V rocket, which uses Russian-made RD-180 engines. ULA speaker Jessica Rye said, "As we manage the transition to the Vulcan launch system, all necessary RD-180 engines to execute the Atlas V flyout are safely stored in our factory in Decatur, Alabama." So, from this statement, it seems that United Launch Alliance had already gathered the RD-180 engines they needed to complete the remaining launches of the Atlas V. Presently, ULA is on the way to shift to their latest launcher, Vulcan Centaur, which is presently under development. Vulcan Centaur will use the BE-4 engine made by Piso Space Company Blue Origin. But ULA has 25 launches scheduled on their Atlas V rocket up to the year 2025. Thus, it's necessary for ULA to continue Atlas V launches. The Russian RD-180 rocket engines are mainly used in the first stage booster of Atlas V rocket. After Russia had invaded Crimea, restrictions were put upon the use of Russian engines in U.S. launch vehicles. The U.S. government then allowed the Defense Department to award contracts only for Atlas V launches, and thus Atlas vehicles remain till now. ULA also buys spare parts and often takes technical support from the RD-180 manufacturer, NPO Energomash. But whether they continue this relation, it's still under little confusion as the U.S. sanctions on Russia didn't clearly state whether they'll put restrictions on getting spares for them. Rye said, "We have agreements for technical support and spares, but if that support is not available, we'll still be able to safely and successfully fly out our Atlas program. ULA is already working for backup supplies." On the 15th of February, ULA announced an agreement with Milling Precision in Wichita, Kansas, to supply components and spare parts for the Atlas V rocket. Rye said, "We will continue to cultivate new supplier relationships to ensure we safely and successfully fly out the program." Tory Bruno, CEO of ULA, said that the company has been flying these types of engines for many years and is not dependent on Energomash for technical expertise. Bruno said, "I have personal experience in flying other people's rockets without their support, which informs my confidence. We like to have a retainer in order to ask questions or do repairs if that were to come up. But we have a lot of experience and expertise here, so we can do without if necessary. Bruno also said, the RD-180 was put on Atlas because the US government asked us to. They wanted to prevent Russian rocket scientists from going to North Korea and Iran after the Cold War. After Crimea in 2014, the US government decided this was no longer a good idea. I came to ULA that summer and started Vulcan.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.